African American artists, and it has political bent, and it has a lot of creativity, and I think you will enjoy it. My name is Lori. Please ask me questions, and I'll tell you if I don't know the answers. But please feel free. I like on my tour for people to look and tell me what they see. I don't talk the whole time. I like to have people look at what they're seeing. So we're going to the front elevator over there.
Skip the line. This is what I wanted to see. Soul of a Nation. Art in the Age of Black Power. Hopefully this video can survive the elevator ride. We'll see. If not, then I'll be back, guys.
How many of you are Brooklynites?
Former.
Anyone from another country here? Okay, please feel free to ask questions. This is fairly recent history, and sometimes I think, oh, everybody knows that, so please feel free to ask questions. I try to get you through this very, very big show in less than an hour. If you get bored or if you have to be somewhere, just disappear. It's okay.
It's okay. Let me take my braids off.
Most of the world had already ended it. So slavery ends and the government says, we're going to have reconstruction. Everybody's going to get 40 acres and a mule. Didn't happen. What happened instead, the formerly enslaved people ended up being tenant farmers, owing their soul to the owner of the land. There were Jim Crow laws, lynchings. The people that were formerly enslaved were treated very, very badly. A lot of them decided to move. We have the Great Migration, the end of the 1800s. People moved to New York, Washington, Philadelphia, Chicago, LA, and they set up communities. And a lot of them came with some education that they got at the traditionally black colleges. Others had educational opportunities in these cities, and there developed intellectual communities of African American peoples in all of those cities, and there were painters as well. And sculptors and artists who worked in other media, and nobody is paying attention to them. So let's go see what they happened in New York.
Not much has changed.
Romare Bearden believed with all his heart that the people of Harlem, the everyday people of Harlem, were art in and of themselves. And he began working in a new field of collage. He takes pictures, cuts them up, glues them on a background, and then uses a photographic process. So here, this is called the White Dove, and these are everyday people. This was Bearden's idea of art. I'd like to show one other Bearden piece over here. those roots go all the way back to Africa. So she's the one who can make you a love potion. She has medicines for herbs. She can put a curse on somebody. So here she is, working in Harlem. So this idea of connecting to Africa runs throughout the whole show. So people are really interested in their roots.
I want to go to the third floor. This one.
Interesting, Firewall lasted another year closed up shop and everybody started doing their own thing. The photography here is another group of artists who were photographers. They were making money with
Marcus Garvey. States of Attica.
Uh,
1968.